this video on the Certified Q&A, let's tackle another question for the Google Cloud Platform Associate Cloud Engineer. It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. In this project scenario, you need to estimate the annual cost of running a BigQuery query that is scheduled to run nightly. What should you do? This is a very regular project requirement where, as an engineer, you will have to give a cost estimate to management so that they can budget how much money needs to be allocated for running a particular application or program. So in doing this, we are going to look at a few options and see what works the very best, knowing that the key part is to estimate the annual cost of running a query. In looking at this question, there are two sets of solutions that we should consider. Should we use gcloud as a command line tool to do this, or should we use bq as a command line tool to do this? As before, we want to quickly eliminate groups of options so that we have lesser options to work with. To do that, let's look at how Google serves BigQuery to you. Anything you do on the cloud runs on VMs, memory, network, and storage. So any service that you use is going to use this physical infrastructure. On top of this physical infrastructure is often a managed service provided to you, for example, BigQuery. When you're working with BigQuery, typically you're working with data, datasets, tables, you're running queries on it, you're importing and exporting data. And whenever you do that, the primary tool to use is BQ. So you do things like BQ query, BQ insert, and so on. Whereas when you're working with the infrastructure, when you're provisioning VMs, memory, network, storage, or creating projects, then you use gcloud. So remember that a project is not physical infrastructure, it's logical infrastructure, but then you still have to create one before you create resources like VMs and network and storage. So even creating projects is done via gcloud. So via gcloud, you will create resources like gcloud compute, gcloud container, gcloud project, whereas BQ will be only for data. Now, in looking at this option that we are estimating the annual cost of running a query, what do we need to run a query? We need the query data to be stored somewhere, which is storage. We need it to be computed somewhere, which is a VM, and also in memory. And this needs to be, you know, sent across a network. So we are also using some amount of bandwidth. All of this is infrastructure. So is this a job for gcloud? The way managed services work is that the infrastructure part is completely handled for you by Google Cloud, and you yourself do not need to manually provision any of the infrastructure part. So when you use a managed service like BigQuery, you only use the BQ tool and you do not concern yourself with resources being allocated and removed. Therefore, in this case, it is fairly clear to see that given that BigQuery is a managed service and all the infra details are hidden for you, the tool you will use to work with BigQuery is going to be BQ, because all you're going to be paying on is based on use, the amount of data involved. And when it's data, BQ is the tool to be used. With that understanding now, we can knock off two of the options A and C, because both of them attempt to use gcloud to get to the result. How about using a BQ estimate, where we determine the amount billed for a single query and then multiply that amount by 365. So this query is going to be run every night once. So if we got the estimate for running it once, it seems to reason that we can multiply that number by 365 to get the estimate for the full year. Now you could ask a question, won't the amount of data change each day? We're not going to run the exact same query on the exact same data. But that is fair, because estimates are always going to be fairly rough. Even let's say when you're budgeting for your annual expenditure at home, you do not know if the cost of bread is going to change in the coming months, if the new budget is going to increase the cost of other items. Therefore, all you can do is make a reasonable estimate, and then if you want, you can add a buffer. But then these estimates are going to be generally rough. So this particular option doesn't seem like a bad idea as of now. Another question is, are we going to query all the data always? Unlikely. Our queries are not going to necessarily run on the full set of data, but usually on a partial set of it. Now, how is this costed to you? You are going to be costed based on use, which is the amount of data involved in your query. And what is that? You will then have to pay the cost for the query itself, but also for the amount of data that is stored. Therefore, this particular option will only use a part of the data which is queried and not consider the entire data that is going to be also stored. Given that, this approach does not account for archived data which is unqueried. And therefore, this option already has some loopholes which makes it unsuitable for us. But a very clear reason why this would not work is that there is no BQ estimate command. This is again another illustration of the situation where even without knowing whether there's a particular command called BQ estimate, you can still come to a reasonable conclusion that this option would not be useful for us. Now, how about option B, which suggests that we do a BQ query dry run. First, we determine the number of bytes read by using the dry run option and then add this to the pricing calculator. So remember, what are we billed based on? It is going to be the data used, the data involved, which is both stored and that is queried. So to get the complete costs, we need to have an estimate of both of them. To start with, does the pricing calculator give us a way to estimate combining both of them? The answer is yes. There is a way to put in a number saying, you know what, I expect this much storage to be there, in this example 10 GB, and I expect these number of queries to run, or these number of queries to run on so much data, which will amount to a total of this much data being queried. If you supply both of those numbers into the pricing calculator, you can get an estimate of the cost, say in this case for 1 month, which you can multiply by the number of months that you're going to run this for. Next question is there an option called dry run? Looking at the documentation, there is something called --- dry run that you can use as a flag to the command line interface. Of course, the BQ command line tool is not the only way to do this. You can also use a dry run parameter when submitting a query job using the API, or you can use a client library, say if you're programming it in Go or Java or Python, or you can also do it via the BigQuery web UI. So it is possible to run a query in the BigQuery console and then get an estimate of the number of bytes that are going to be processed by this. So in both of these options, or in all of these options, you have a way to get the number of bytes that are going to be queried by using a dry run option. One side tip over here is that to reduce the number of bytes that are going to be queried, you should try to restrict the amount of data queried. So the less data that is queried from all of the data that is available, you're going to incur a lesser cost. Now that we know that there is a dry run option, which is also available via the BQ command line tool, which we can then supply to the pricing calculator to get the complete estimate, this becomes the best option for us. What are the key learnings from this question? One, gCloud is to be used when you're setting up your project, when you're giving IAM permissions, and when you are provisioning infrastructure. You use the BQ command line tool whenever you're working with BigQuery data, when you're importing and exporting data, when you're inserting data, when you're querying data, when you are editing and creating tables and data sets. BigQuery is a managed service, and when it's a managed service, you don't provision the infrastructure. You transfer that to Google Cloud itself, which does all the hard work for you on that and just allows you to use the service as a very simple option. How are you costed? You're going to be costed based on how much data you use in the case of BigQuery. For BigQuery, billing is based on the data stored, the data queried, and if you're using streaming data, then also on the amount of data inserted. If you're using batch inserts though, then you are not costed on those inserts. It is possible to estimate how much data is queried using various approaches of the dry run option, whether it's via the command line tool, the API call, the client libraries, or via the web interface. You can put this information then into the pricing calculator to give you the total estimate of the cost. A pro tip would be that you should query lesser data to reduce the amount of cost that you will incur. I'll leave you with a few references on BigQuery, on optimizing BigQuery, on controlling the costs using the pricing calculator, and a reference to the BQ command line tool. All right, now it's time for you to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Go ahead, do that right now, because there's loads of great content coming up for learning Google Cloud and preparing for the certifications.